truth in me. Cause God, he put me here to leave a legacy. To leave a legacy. I wanna give the world all the truth in me. Cause God, he put me here to leave a legacy. To leave a legacy.
In a time where women don't feel safe anymore and children don't feel safe anymore. So now we are, as men, sitting down and coming up with solutions on how about do we create a safe space for them and ensuring that wherever they, where they go, they can walk freely and safe.
Today is a day where we are actually saying, let's come together and have a conversation, an intergenerational conversation on what we're seeing in our own communities.
It's so great that you guys are here, because we can't do this by ourselves. We are just one organization. It's true, we have many partners, but we're just one.
As an organization, our mandate is to change the way society treats children. And when children are dying, and when women who take care of children are dying, it becomes not just a matter of work, but it's a matter of concern for the society.
The youngest victim we assisted was 2 months old. Perpetrator, biological father. The eldest was 108 years old, Gogo. Can you imagine? Who's the perpetrator? Man. Us.
We see women as objects, and yeah, well, what I've seen is that now we don't respect the women. Like, for example, we're at school, well, I'll see one of my friends, they'll see a young girl passing by and call that young girl as fresh meat.
What does that mean that I can do? Well, that means as a woman, if I hear a comment being made by a man or a woman that is disparaging or that is in that same category of what we were talking about earlier, the comment about fresh meat or any other disparaging comment, what will I do? Well, I should tell that person why that's unacceptable.
When you go to a game, if ever we can use the PA system, public address system, to say, let us all stand up and say, not in our names. As men, we are saying, not in our name.
Yeah, I think it's a national concern. It's an international concern. So we are part of the concern, SAFA. And we are here also to make a contribution in the dialogue, because we feel, as a society, we need to stand up and bring an end to violence against women and children.
I'd like to first thank the Nelson Mandela Children's Fund for inviting us as Africa Tikkun to come and express our views in this particular issue that we're having, this particular issue that we are constantly facing in our daily lives, not just in this 16 days of activism period, but then on a daily basis. My name is Kanya Subanda, and I am the alumni president at Africa Tikkun Uthando, and also the Young Urban Men Facilitator. Yes, we are trash, but trash can be recycled. That means we can be renewed, we can be revived, we can strive for a better future.
We say, what is missing now? I think we are standing in the middle of a massive institutional failure. I think our government systems have collapsed. Because the kind of violence we see is not just people have gone evil. People haven't gone evil. It's because they can get away with it.
We are all in the same boat. We are all sinking together, trying to fight the violence together. One is rowing that way, one is rowing the other way, and we're all just rowing, but we're just still sinking. Because no one is paying the price.
What needs to be done is that every single one of us in the places where we work, in the places where we live, in our families, in our communities, we all need to take a role. We all need to take action. We all need to understand the challenges of ensuring equality for men and women and boys and girls, ensuring safe environments for our children to be raised. And we all need to commit to taking actions within our families and our communities to address and eliminate the problem.
Big companies are developing, you know, high-tech software to increase sales. But I'm saying, why don't we develop high-tech software to drive education as well as the message against violence on children and women?
First, I think the most important thing is not to see gender. If we can be human beings first and start loving each other and respect each other, I think those are the key and the fundamentals that we can start doing.
And this ribbon, I'm also going to put on this ribbon every day of my life to show that every day is a no to GBV. Thank you.
My name is Zola Sabelo. I pledge to protect the children, the women, the little girls all around Africa.
I want to give the world all the truth in me, because God, he put me here to leave a legacy. To leave a legacy.